What's up, guys? Kevin with On Point Pro Styles in Gainesville, Georgia. This video is going to be about the latest updates from FilmCut, the plotter software available from plotterdepot.com. The latest version is 1.6.5. They've added some really cool features I think will be very useful, and they've also changed a couple of things. There's a lot to go over, so let's dive right in and I'll show you the updates. Okay, so we've got the software open. I've zoomed in a little bit so you can see it a little better. First thing to note is before the update, the origin point was at your top left here, which was a little confusing because that would basically or technically be the right side of your machine. And then this was the left side of your machine. So it was mirrored. So what was on your screen was mirrored compared to what actually printed. It was a little confusing. So they fixed that now. They've then flipped this. So now this is the right side or the origin point of your machine. And this is the left side or furthest from origin point. This would be your roll or media. And this side is the front looking at your machine. So a little less confusing, nice update. Next one, we're gonna look at the VIN lookup tool. This took me a little bit to get used to, so a few things to note. I'm gonna copy and paste. Now I will say that if you just paste it, it's not going to search. It actually has to be typed. Maybe we'll see a copy paste search function in a future update, but for now, simply paste it. If you're a copy paster, delete the last digit, type it, hit enter, and it will then use that to search, automatically bringing up the car by VIN. No guesswork. There's a couple cars out there that, for example, a Chevy Cruze, there's larger rear quarters and smaller rear quarters, pretty annoying. It's only about an inch difference. You gotta measure them to find out the difference and select the right car. And with this no guesswork. That works for tint and PPF as well. And I will say, if you go from tint to PPF, naturally the PPF is going to want to know a little bit more about the vehicle because there could be side markers or no side markers, but it gets you very, very close. So food for thought, very cool. So to turn this feature off, just click show all and you're back to searching a vehicle as you normally would. So let's switch to PPF. I want to show you some of the updates they did there. Let's grab us an Acura TLX sedan. So they've added the ability to manipulate the patterns, cut the patterns, pretty neat. So I'm gonna select the wheel, rear splash, left side, and I'm only gonna work on this pattern, so I'll delete this one. I'm going to click edit, which brings up our editing panel here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bend this. So the bending feature is gonna be best for if you have a very large piece and you wanna bend it just a little bit to better fit the roll that you're cutting on. It's a neat feature. So we're gonna click the bend option here. I'm going to right click, click edit template, put in my bending point. So I wanna bend this here. If you click your up button, you can see that it is bending it outward and vice versa. The down button is gonna bend it inward. So I'm gonna delete that, restart my pattern. We'll use the same one, get rid of this piece. So now I want to add material here. I'm gonna click the resize function. Then I'm going to right click, edit template, put in my add points, and I'm gonna add a half an inch to that. So I'm gonna select half an inch, click plus, and there you have it. Alternatively, if I wanted to just take that piece and make it larger all the way around, I can simply click offset, right click, edit, and then just simply say I want a quarter inch added to the entire piece, click the plus button, and it's now bigger by a quarter inch. So neat features there. The last one, we're just going to, doesn't matter what's over here, we're just gonna edit template and say, I wanna cut this piece in half. Probably not useful for a piece like this, but other pieces, I'm sure bumpers and such, you'll find it very handy. So I'm going to put in, whoops, I'm gonna click here and click here. I'm gonna right click and click separate template. So now it puts a cut here. So your machine's gonna cut the whole piece out with a cut here, making it two pieces. Pretty neat feature. Like I said, for larger pieces, you wanna split up into parts. Makes it a lot easier to do that. All right, so the save function. This is a really neat one, long time coming. Actually, we'll just use the VIN to pull up our previous Nissan. We'll switch it to tint. All right, let's use the most common. Let's use the back window. So let's say I cut this pattern before and it's just, it's a little short for me. I'd like it to go a little bit taller. So we're going to resize and right click the template, put in our resize points, which are usually going to be toward the top or the bottom, depending on which way you want to go. I'm going to add a half inch to the pattern. It's going to add that half inch portion. And now I want to save that pattern. So we're going to click save and we're going to save it as back glass. Pretty handy, pretty cool. We're going to show all again, and then we can go to our saved patterns here. And there you have it. I've done a set of doors for an F-150. I added a half inch to the bottom for more tuck room. And then we have that pattern we just added more length on. So pretty neat feature. You can now save patterns. You've got the universal button here, which is pretty interesting. A lot of this stuff, I really don't even know what a lot of this stuff is. You'll just have to play with it. But one thing that's pretty neat is they have the universal eyebrows down here with the contour cut. Pretty neat. They always come up as multiples. Just delete one. And now you have a universal eyebrow you can use as a contour, which is really neat. It's a neat feature. So that's that. Reviews. Usually, let's go back to the VIN. Oh, I gotta have vehicle selected. Okay, we're back on the VIN now. We searched our Nissan Altima. I want to point out, I can't show it now because I'm not going to waste a piece of tint to cut it, but say you cut a door. After you cut that door, a little review link will pop up here where you can actually give feedback on the pattern. One thing I did find is that if you switch to a different pattern, that review link goes away and it's gone. So it's almost in essence saying, print this, cut it out, go install it, and then tell us what you think. So not my favorite, but there's another way. So they've added this feature called cut history. Very cool, neat little feature. I'm gonna look at last week, what I cut, click search. Gives you a list of each and every pattern that you cut. And if you look far to your right, there's a very usable review link that will pop up a box that you can give them stars. You can include a comment about why you gave them those stars. You can even tell them that they're allowed to contact you in the event that they need to, giving them a email address. It gives them all the information they need, your operating system, kind of plotter, your product ID to identify you, as well as the software version. So food for thought, guys. I'm just gonna throw this out there. If you give them any less than 5 on a pattern, explain it. Tell them why they didn't get the 5th star. So if it's anything ever less than 5, and this goes for reviews or anything, it's very wise and helpful to any company to explain why they didn't hit 5 stars. If it's anything less than 5, I would highly suggest including a comment and letting them know why. So pretty neat. They can get that feedback. They can work on patterns using our feedback as the installers. That's pretty exciting. Huge update there. Plus being able to see what you saw or what you cut today, this week, last week, this month, last month, year to date. Pretty neat. So that's pretty much it. As you can see, even I'm still kind of figuring my way out through all of the new updates, but they're very useful, very handy. It's amazing to see this software grow from where it was to what it is now, and they continue to working on it. So pretty exciting. I have some feedback that I'll be giving them in hopes that they'll be adding more and more as the days go on. So pretty excited to see the next update that they have for us. But if you need any help, reach out to plotterdepot.com. They're happy to help. Reach out to me. I'm happy to help. Kevin Rogers, Nonpoint Pro Styles in Gainesville, Georgia. Look me up on all the socials. I'm there. Comment on this video. Reach out to me if you need any help. But to recap, you've got the nesting box, which is flipped and it now mimics real life. What you actually see is going to cut. You have the VIN search. Remember, it has to be typed. So if you're a copy paster, just delete the last digit and type it, hit enter. It'll work. It'll search the tint or the PPF for you. You have the new PPF editing features, the bending, the resize, all that good stuff. So pretty neat there. Play with that if you're a PPF guy. I'm sure those are going to be very useful. You have the save function, really neat, very useful function. I don't edit very many patterns. Most of them are in very good shape. However, there are some cars I'll drop a little bit to the bottom of the doors. If I know I do that on every time, then I'll just go ahead and save that pattern and go and cut the saved pattern. So pretty neat there. The reviews, remember, they don't really work after you cut the pattern. If you're one like me that cuts a whole car out and then installs everything, but you have that cut history now that you can go to reference all your old cuts. And if you were happy with them and want to take the time to leave a review, I would highly suggest you do that. It only makes the patterns that much better. So again, plotterdepot.com for the FilmCut software. Reach out to them if you need any help. Reach out to me, Kevin, On Point Pro Styles. See you on the next one.